My target speaker, Varunesh, is attempting speech number 5 from the manual Humanistic Speaking. And the objectives are, use exaggeration to tell a humorous story. Entertain the audience, effectively use body language and voice to enhance the story. Time of the time is 5 to 7 minutes. All the best.
Talking about the speaker, he is a techie by profession, dreamer by heart, and a toastmaster in making. He says that he hasn't chalked out a bucket list yet, but he has surely a list of things that he wants to strike off. He, according to him, he is the genie of Aladdin. He is ruthlessly loyal, has a moral compass that always points north, and is capable of anything he sets his mind to. He is always there, and you just have to put your hands together to summon him. So can we have our hands together to summon him?
Toastmasters, my extracurricular activities. minus the bird watching part. And then, as per my friend's instruction, I brought out the rhetorical device. Wanted to give her a compliment, but something happened. A lot of drama woke up. Something happened. I looked into her eyes and said, "Why are you looking so beautiful?" Ladies and gentlemen, two extra words in a sentence have never caused a havoc in somebody's life. Two extra words, and I was just tossed out of the window. She was laughing. I felt I was humorous. Felt like a humorous piece contest, but she was not laughing at me. She was mocking. I didn't realize. And I kept paying. She was laughing at my expense, and I kept paying. It was a disaster. I went back home. Like any other exam I have given in my life, my parents called me to know the status of how I wrote my exam. How did it go? So I explained it. And I didn't know that I have to qualify this exam as well. My dad says, "You're a hopeless case. Remember, nothing that we can do about you. It takes hard time to find a date nowadays. You got one chance and you screwed it up." When nothing works, you resign to God's greatness. And I thought, God is there to help everybody. I'm sure He has found somebody who should be found by me. Or, in the other case, He should find me. So I said, "God, see, I don't know what things you are busy with. But can you please spare some time to tell the girl to find me? My GPS is not working. So can you point her to the right direction, like right here, behind Marchandi Bridge in this particular house? She can find me. And if not, then we can meet at the same place. I often go to a place called Postmaster. So please send her a guest at one of the speeches I'm going to give, and probably she liked my speech. And we can actually go on a coffee date and I can make an icebreaker and the rest of the stuff." I don't know whether God has heard my calling or not. But I want to keep coming back to the stage, looking at the audience and trying to find one of the audience smiling at me, and probably at the end of the speech we can shake hands and say, "Hey, my name is Varanish. Nice to meet you."